So I am back with my weekly readings. I'm very sorry that last week I was not able to bring in the readings. I had some health issues, so that's the reason I was not able to bring. So now we are going to do from the 9th of August to the 15th of August. First of all, I thank you all because a lot of people had messaged me asking, ma'am, where is the weekly readings? And you know, we are missing it a lot. So I'm very grateful to you all for that. And always thank you for loving and supporting me and always standing by me in whatever way I am. So thank you all. So this is going to be for the 9th August to 15th August. Now, this time what I have done is I have kept three archangels and three crystals. Now, this is Archangel Michael and this is a amethyst. Okay. So, and this is Shamuel, Archangel Shamuel, and this is my Labradorite. Okay. And this is Gabriel with a red amber. Okay, so I will repeat. I have kept Michael with amethyst, Shamuel with labradorite, Gabriel with amber. So now just take a deep breath, focus on your relaxing your body, and just breathe in and breathe out 2-3 times, and then say, I call on my angels, archangels, divine, to guide me as to how my this week is going to be. Or you can call on whichever god goddesses you like, and you can call on them and then you can work on this. So our first set, which will be, is the Archangel Michael with the amethyst. So I'm just going to keep this separately. I will keep bringing this one by one. Okay, I think by now you people would have decided whether it is Michael, Shamuel, or your Gabriel. So now this is your first set, the Michael and the amethyst crystal. So I think most of you all who have picked Michael are either seeking for protection or are clinging on to a lot of things which no longer need to be thought about or need to be worried about. That is what I feel when I am seeing this card, this Michael. And amethyst, maybe you are having sleep issues, maybe you are emotionally very down, you are stressed out. That's the reason you have selected the amethyst. But ultimately, there's no point stressing in this world, because I always say stress is not the solution of any problem at all. So it is, you know, just be positive and just say this shall pass too, and things will automatically start passing and becoming good. So today I'm going to take three cards from my tarot for you all. I just felt I should take three. So I'm taking three cards from my, I have used my psychic tarot this time. So this is my three cards for your tarot. I shall open soon. Before that, as usual, I will take my other cards and I will take out the cards and keep for you all, so that, you know, we can work. So as I was saying, maybe call on Michael and do a cord cutting for you. Maybe what you can do is you can even invoke his energies. You can say, I call on Archangel Michael to keep me shielded, to keep me protected. You can even close your eyes and see him coming, and you know, with his sword cutting cords which no longer are needed. So I don't know, I just felt I should take two cards for a love reading today. So I'm taking two cards for you all for the love reading. Okay. And sometimes we just need to let go of the past which no longer is of use to us. We should also understand one thing, that past is never going to change. Past is never going to bring in a lot of changes. A lot of cards fell down. So maybe financially also you are stressed. That's why the cards fell. There's no point even financially stressing, if you ask me. I would say don't stress financially. So let's take a two card for your finances. Okay, now there goes your finances, and we will be also seeing on your health, because your psychic, the psychic tarot will speak on your career overall. So love, abundance, health. I don't know why I am picking two cards today, but I am picking two cards. So there goes love, there goes abundance, there goes healing. And this, I am taking a goddess oracle ka message. So this I will be just taking one card and I will be keeping here. Now, since my runes workshop is starting, I was taking out some extra pointers for runes. So I thought, why not take out one rune also with these. And I'm taking one unicorn ka card, general message. Okay, two cards have come, so we will work with that only. So I will keep all your cards here and let's start. Michael with amethyst, those who have taken, it's a beautiful card, see. Prosperity begins. So somewhere You are bound to have a prosperous week this week. I see a lot of beautiful grounding energies, and I see, the peach is what is coming in my eyes. So maybe whatever you're exploring, you're going to grow. So see now, you are stressed out. I was telling you this card, this has come maybe because you're stressed. So now the cards are saying don't stress. Things will change, things will be beautiful. Everything will go well because prosperity is really good. Now for that, what it is, I feel is, it says spiritual strength. Now here I feel, you should become strong with the connect to the divine, and you should understand one thing, that he is there to take care of you, and he is there to safeguard you somewhere. When I see this card, I don't know, though it's a green colored picture and all, but I feel it's Michael who is just standing there and protecting you, because you've already selected Michael today. So maybe he is just trying to protect you, he is trying to safeguard you, but you need to surrender to them. See, in life, nothing will happen on its own unless we don't believe in it, and we don't manifest it, and we don't surrender to it, because the divine also says you need to surrender. Surrender your worries to him. Tell him to take care of it. Tell him whatever it is that is troubling you, and maybe you will find some solution. Surrender to the divine. Make yourself spiritually strong. When I'm saying make yourself spiritually strong, maybe what I'm trying to tell is focus more on meditation. Work on your psychicness. When I say psychicness, every day morning, maybe for 5-10 minutes, you can work on having a small meditation followed by a chamomile tea. It works beautiful in that ways. In fact, those who have amethyst should carry amethyst with them this week fully. And if you don't have amethyst, maybe you can call on Archangel Michael and use his protection. Whenever you feel you are low or you are left out, then maybe Archangel Michael is the best thing. Now the last card, the last tarot thought which came, psychic card which came, was destiny. Now this is another beautiful card. If you see here, I see this card as everything is becoming one, or everything is combining and coming. So maybe whatever has been troubling you, whatever has been putting you down, now is the time that it's going to start sorting out, and things are going to fall in place. And when these things fall in place, you will be very, very happy, and you will feel that yes, this is what I wanted, and this is what is happening. So now again, this is a beautiful runes card. I just love this card. This is called Barkana. Now, if there is someone who's going in for a pregnancy test this week, then be rest assured that your test is going to be good. If you are looking into this reading with the point of view that will I bear a child, then I would say yes, you will bear a child. You'll be very happy. But this is gift. Barkana is gift. So mostly, this is going to be a very gifted week, and it's going to be a beautiful and a joyful week, because all the cards which are coming are just falling in place. Now the goddess card we will read in the end. We will work towards the healing. Okay, divine intervention and do more research. Now here it says, this is a beautiful reading here. It says, dear Archangel Raphael, thank you for being with the name of the person, and for helping with the situation you have to say. I have faith in divine intervention, and I fully accept your guidance now. Now here I will tell you what it is for me when this card I'm reading. Maybe what you should do is, whenever you feel your health is not good or you're feeling low, all you have to do is just sit somewhere where you will not be disturbed. Close your eyes and call on Archangel Michael. Now when you're calling on Archangel Michael, you just need to say that I call on Archangel Raphael to help me with the health issue that I am facing right now, so that I come out of it and I am healthy, fit and fine. And imagine Archangel Raphael standing right on top of you. He is blessing you. As he is blessing, from his hand, a lot of green light is flowing in your body and is covering your full body and aura with green light. All you have to do is just this, and it will happen. Here it says that you need to start understanding or start doing more research on what is it that you need to keep yourself healthy. Maybe a change in the diet plan. Maybe you can also work on, waking up on time, sleeping on time, doing your exercises. Something which you have not been doing for quite some time. The cards say that you have to work on that and do that. Now coming to your abundance. So beautiful. Organize for success. Remember when the cards fell down, I said maybe financially also you're stressed. So organize it. Organize your plans. Organize your finances. Plan your finances, plan your expenses, plan your income. See what has to be done as a plan of action so that you are able to successfully get the money that you desire, and also you are able to successfully plan your finances and be happy with it. So have courage to ask. Now it says ask for help. So if you feel that the money is more, how much ever I plan, I will not be able to, you know, get that much of money or arrange that much of money, then you can go in and ask, because the angels here are saying ask for help. So obviously it's very clear that the help is coming your way. So there's actually nothing to worry at all. Now, love. Power. You instinctively know what is right for you. Now, if you see here, this card, you see the image. It says, if you feel you're stuck in a relationship which is toxic, then just say a no and walk away. Now, most of the times, we don't understand whether this relationship is meant for us or no. So, now, if you have selected this set of one, and if you feel you're in a relationship where you don't know whether you need to stick on to it or move forward, or whether you need to get into a divorce or get into a mutual agreement, if your heart says to get separated and go, then please do it. If your heart says no, I need to give it one more chance, then give it one more chance. So this week you need to decide, because whatever you decide, that will start becoming fruitful. That is what is your love card saying. Now coming to the ground. So now this is another amazing card. Green Tara. Now when we say Kuan Yin, it is more like help now, for healing basically. Now when I say Green Tara, she is a lady who helps you in getting your work started. Whatever you plan, whatever you desire, she helps you in making the plan a success. So from the starting, if you see, there is prosperity, there is happiness, there is divine energy and healing for you all. Even your finances, you can ask and you will get it. Love life also, it says if you feel no, then no. So start delegating, start implementing basically whatever you feel is right for you. Now coming to the unicorn. This is a beautiful card. It says the Christ, open the door to the kingdom of the heaven. So the heaven is open in the sense, good things are coming in your way. You need to just accept it and you need to just work towards it beautifully. And the next one is you are blessed with love, compassion, wisdom. Now these two are the most amazing unicorn cards. So those who have taken set one, be happy. It's a blessed week. It's a happy week. It's a week where things will really go well. So what is there to worry for? And if you all have resonated with this reading, if you all have liked this reading, then do share, like and comment here. Now if you comment, this time I will not be telling what I am going to bring in, but I will bring in something as a surprise for you all. So do share, like and comment, and also subscribe to the channel, because many of you keep asking me when is the message for the week coming. So if you have subscribed and if you have pressed the bell icon, you will automatically be notified when it comes. So our set one is done. Now we shall start with our set two, the Samuel and the Labradorite. Now those who have selected Labradorite, I want to say one thing. Maybe you all are waiting for magic to happen in life. Because for me, Labradorite is magic. For me, Labradorite is where you enhance your psychic abilities, you start working towards your manifestation. So if you have taken Labradorite, then you are looking for magic. And if you have taken Samuel, then somewhere you are looking for love, compassion. Maybe you are looking for self-love. Now here I feel more than seeking love from outside, work on self-love. So that self-love will give you the love that you desire, and automatically you will attract the love that you're looking for. You can also, if you have a Labradorite, you can wear a Labradorite. You can try burning pink candles this week, because Samuel has come, and try wearing something in pink or carrying a kerchief or something which is pink in color. That also will work beautifully. And gift yourself something, because when you gift yourself something, it means you love yourself that much. And when you love yourself that much, it means that, you know, the universe is also loving you. So I have taken three cards from my psychic tarot. Okay. And yes, Labradorite works beautifully when you want to enhance your psychic abilities also. So maybe you have been wanting to see grow spiritually, and you've been wanting to see how to work on your spirituality. So that also the card can, the crystal can mean, and that is why the crystal has a calling for you. Now what you can do is, as I had said, people who have taken Michael, the same I would say here is meditate, but here meditate on your third eye and enhance the energies of your third eye. Work on it in such a way that from the third eye you are able to focus and manifest something that you desire and things fall in place. So again, I'm taking out two abundance and two love cards. Okay, and as I said, runes workshop is coming, so this time I'm taking one runes card also, and we will see what is there in health for you through our Archangel Raphael. Goddess guidance. At last, my unicorn cards. Let's see whether for you one is coming or two cards are coming. Let's see, whatever comes out, then that is for you. Okay, so one card has only come. Okay, so now we will keep these cards here and I shall start with your cards. Okay, now this is a awesome card, the waiting game. Now when I say waiting game, it means maybe you're waiting. As I said, labradorite means magic. You're expecting magic to happen. You're expecting things to start moving forward. You're expecting, why is it that I am suffering? Why me? What is happening? Why is it my things that are, you know, not falling in place? So maybe it is just for some more time for this wait. And as the wait gets over, this phase will change and you will be very, very happy and successful. Now again, heart chakra. If you all remember, I had told you all in the starting, for Samuel, do self-love. So the heart chakra is again a cross indication saying that, you know, you need to work on your heart. If my heart is happy, if my heart is flourishing with joy and love, then I spread the love, and at the same time, I will be able to, you know, attract what it is that I desire, because that is very important when I want to work on self-love. When I'm happy from inside, when my soul is beautiful and happy, then everything comes in place. Because even if you take, you might be wondering that for career, what is my heart got to do? When I have a happy heart, what happens is when I go to my office, I go with a happy mind. And when I go with happy mind, I'll be able to focus on my work more happily. When I am able to keep my patience, like, you know, I'm patient, I know things will change, I know my boss will understand, I know reciprocations will come. When we think in that terms, what happens is, we are again opening our heart with possibilities of changes to happen, and that in turn what happens is the triumphant success. So if you see, the cards have given you the answer. All you need to do is wait for some more time. Whatever it is, whatever magic is it is that you're looking at, whatever change it is that you're looking at, the change is coming, and the change is coming very, very soon. So you don't have to worry about the change, you just need to go with the flow. So we will first do your love cards, your abundance cards. Okay, see, I told you in the starting, if you're looking for your boss to understand, then yes, he will understand, and there's a lot of chance that, you know, you will be rewarded for what hard work you've been doing, which says raise or promotion. So in your career, if you're looking in for a promotion or an appraisal coming in, it will work in your favor and will be really, really good. In fact, you'll be very happy that whatever you expected, you have got that. So that's a beautiful card, and it says bountiful nature. Now this again, I would love to connect with the heart chakra, that give your heart bountiful love, lot of pink light, lot of pink energy, and everything will start falling in place. You will feel very happy the way things are moving. You will be satisfied that yes, I am able to enjoy the fruits of the hard work and the sacrifice that I have been doing in the past. And the magic which you are expecting when you selected the labradorite, that magic will be on its way to make you happy and to make you smile. Now coming to the, now this again, see all the cards, that is why I love these cards. It says look inside yourself. Right now, when you see this carpet, it says look inside yourself. It is examine what is making you feel this way. So self-love. Again and again, your cards are talking about self-love. Give yourself the love. Give yourself the time. Maybe gift yourself something. Maybe do something that you really love doing the most. You know, work on it. If you feel going for a walk makes you happy, then go for a walk. If you feel buying something for you which you have not bought for a long time makes you happy, then please go ahead and buy it. So whatever makes you happy, please do that. And you will be happy to know that, you know, things have fallen in place and you are able to love yourself. Now this is a card which says when you pass this world, you don't take anything but your soul. So again, the card is insisting that make beautiful memories, live the moment of the present, let go of things which no longer are good for you, be happy, give yourself a lot and lot of self-love and everything will fall in place. Now let's see, what is your healing cards? Okay, you need to go for a massage. So maybe the cards are also saying that, you know, do something which you really, really love doing. So go for a massage, go for some spa treatment. You deserve to get the happiness that is lacking for quite some time. So go and fetch that happiness. No one is going to stop you. The world may talk, but the world is not going to be with you. So just go and just live your life. Now this one says, use your natural healing abilities. Here, I feel as if it is, you know, asking you to spend time with your pets. So if you are a pet lover, maybe the moment I see dog, I'm a dog mother, so I end up talking about pets. So if you are a pet lover, take out some time, sit in your open garden, open nature, and spend time with them. Just be with them and love them, and you will see beautiful changes around you. Okay, now your runes. Runes is again a beautiful rune, Sovilo. I feel Sovilo is swift. Get strong, get going. It's going to be a week of beautiful, beautiful, super powerful strength and energies, and as you go with the flow, you will feel you're successful in controlling anything that has been troubling you. Now the goddess card, true love. See how beautifully all cards are falling in place. It says true love. The romantic stirrings in your heart have propelled the universe to deliver great love to you. So give yourself the true love, and the true love that you're seeking for is on its way very soon. Now your card of unicorn. You are unlimited, so aim for the stars. Aspiration. Dream big, think big, so that you will achieve whatever it is that you desire. So I hope you all enjoyed and resonated with this reading. If yes, then do share and subscribe the channel, like it, leave a comment. As I said today, I will not say what I am going to bring in as a surprise, but I will bring in some surprise for those who like and comment in the video. And now coming to the third one, you have selected Gabriel and Amber. Gabriel is wisdom, wherein Amber is trying to strengthen your aura, trying to look forward and make your aura super strong. Now when I say time to make your aura super strong, it means somewhere you have not been able to focus on yourself, on your energies, because of which you are finding it difficult to come out of the situations which need attention. So Gabriel says, use your wisdom. Use your wisdom, call on me, I shall also guide you with the wisdom, I shall also give you guidance, so that you are able to achieve, or you are able to come out of the situation which is troubling you, you are able to come to a decision which you are looking for. So I am taking three cards here. Now you can also work with red candles this month, this week, so that you are able to be energetic, you are able to get the right energy and the right stamina to focus and achieve that you want. Now this is your abundance card, so I'm again taking two cards. As I said, you know, this time I felt I should take more cards in abundance. And yes, what I was saying is also because you have selected Amber, work on your root chakra more, strengthen your root chakra, keep yourself grounded. Now, because you're strengthening the root chakra, it doesn't mean that you will not ground yourself. Grounding is also needed in order to get clarity in whatever it is that you are looking for. If you are having certain questions and you don't know what is the net result, then just leave it to the divine, submit it to the divine, and focus on your chakras, focus on your healing. Try burning red candles, try wearing something in red or carrying a red kerchief, because you need a lot of energy and your root chakra needs a lot of cleansing. If you have selected this set, then your root actually needs a lot and lot of cleansing, and amazing grounding is also needed. So work towards that. Okay, and let's see what your cards have come. Now let's see if you are getting unicorn, one card or two card, based on whatever comes. I will take out. Oh wow, two cards have come. Right, good. So let's see what the cards are saying. Okay, first card, love begins. Now I don't mean technically love का लव विच बिगिंस हियर आई फील द यूनिवर्स हैज स्टार्टेड पोरिंग गुड थिंग्स टू यू वॉट एवर हैज बीन ट्रबलिंग यू वॉट एवर हैज बीन गिविंग यू लॉट ऑफ डिस्टर्ब्ड माइंडसेट दैट इज गेटिंग क्लियर द पाथवे इज गेटिंग फॉर्म्ड maybe for your career, maybe for your prosperity, maybe for your business, whatever it is that you're starting new, the universe has started loving you and your idea, and the universe is standing there for you so that you will be blessed. Okay, now the next one is financial and material changes. So here I don't see this as a negative card, because I feel here you have kept your hand on the changes that are happening, and you have decided that yes, this is the changes I need, and this is how I need the changes to come. So that is the reason universe is blessing you, and universe is helping you in achieving whatever it is that you want in terms of career and finances. Because see here, material harvest. So what I said somewhere is working, because the universe is saying that yes, I am ready to help you. I am ready to get you the right guidance, provided you are ready to accept the guidance that I am giving, and you are openly surrendering yourself to me. Because when you surrender yourself to the universe will be more than ready to help you and to give you the right path, or to take you to the right path. Let's see your love cards again in this new beginning. So maybe something new is coming in love also. A new adventure awaits you. So those who are looking for marriage proposals, maybe you will get some good proposal. And if someone is proposing you, then again, it's a new beginning in life for you. And this says, if there is something that you want to be, what will you be? Now, as I said, these cards again are somewhere interrelating. If you have been looking for a partner, and if you have been feeling that, you know, I am not getting the partner the way I want, I am not getting the right love or the right way of attention that I am expecting, then look into yourself. See what it is that is stopping you from getting the type of love that you want, and work on that. Focus on that. Work on those energies. Maybe sometimes we create our own blockages when it comes to finances, love, or any of our situations in life. So see, and I think you will surely get your answers. Okay. Donation, teething, and charitable work. So whenever this card has come, I have always said donate some percentage of your income to the needy and the poor, and the universe will bless you abundantly. So maybe that is what it's saying. But the second card which has come is severe vows of poverty. Maybe you are thinking you don't have anything, you are lacking money, you are lacking abundance, you are lacking everything that you feel is not there, but everything is there. Cut that thought, come out of that thought that all this is not there, and start moving towards abundance. I remember in my prosperity workshop years back, I had taught them something called as a blessed box, where I used to tell them once a month, keep some 10 rupees note in some garden or somewhere, and don't look at it and just walk away. And when you do that, if someone in need gets that money, then you are blessed in return, because in abroad it's a very famous thing which many people follow. So in that ways, many people tried and they were able to see tremendous changes in their lives. So same way, you can also start doing that. Donate some amount of your income as charity, and whatever you donate, I'm sure the universe is going to give 10-20 times of whatever you are giving it. Now coming to your health card. Okay, it says you need to trust the universe that you're healthy, you're fit, and you're fine. Because next card which comes is sunlight. So here, if you see, for sunlight it says you are asking universe to, or Archangel Raphael, to help you in such a way that you are able to live healthy, fit, and fine. But you are already healthy, fit, and fine, so you don't have to worry about your health. Maybe it's just small stresses which is troubling you, but overall your health is perfectly fine, and you don't have to actually think about anything when it comes in terms of health. Now your runes card, Fehu. Prosperous week, lot of money is coming, lot of good things are coming, abundance in whatever you try and in whatever you do, the luck is in your favor this week. Okay now here, express yourself through creative arts. That's a goddess card for you. She's saying express yourself, do what you like doing, be more creative, spend time with your creativeness, spend time with the universe. Whatever you like doing, do that, and you will have a beautiful day. See, oh, beautiful the cards are. It says prosperity and rainbow. So those who have picked up set 3 are actually the luckiest, because prosperity is there, rainbow is there, unicorns are blessing, archangels are blessing, everyone is blessing you. It is just that you need to come out of the thought process which is actually troubling you, and you will be happy this week. So I hope you all enjoyed and resonated this reading. So if so, then do like it, do subscribe to the channel, and do press the bell notification so that you are notified when I come, when I bring in these videos next time. And those who like and comment, I shall be giving them some surprise reading as usual, as I keep giving week after week. So you all have a blessed and a tremendous awful week ahead, and may you all be blessed with good health, lot of abundance, lot of happiness, and may all your wishes come true. Thank you and take care.